So right now, before I answer that question of why successful entrepreneurs or rich people buy fancy cars, toys, or jets, or whatever it is, why don't you comment below, why do you think, you know, right now in your perspective, in your position, would you buy these things and these toys and stuff, and why would you buy it? Would you rather, do you agree that you should put that money into your business, have that invested and grow it, instead of putting it into a fancy toy or something? So I want you to comment below and let me know. Hey, so YouTube, I want to thank you for watching the videos on here. I just wanted to say one important thing. I want you to go on the videos and hit that alarm button there. Make sure you get notifications on the videos. Even though you're subscribed to the videos, it's important that, you know, whenever future videos are released, that you guys get the first notification group. It's going to be very exciting when I see you guys actually get notifications on the videos. Even when they're released, when you're subscribed to the channel, you guys don't get notifications for it. So make sure you hit that alarm button right here, somewhere here. You hit that alarm button, you'll get notifications on videos.
Why do successful people drive fancy cars, have a nice mansion, or a private jet?
I think it's a choice that most of the time when people are successful and they're rich, they make the decision to buy these fancy cars, the Lamborghinis, the mansions, and all this, these fancy toys. I just don't think it's realistic or practical to have a lot of these spending money to acquire these things, because you can leverage them to be able to grow your own business. So for example, if you had $250,000 to spend to buy a Lamborghini, for me, I'd rather take the $250,000, either bring on 5 to 10 more people to grow the business, or I could use $250,000 to put into marketing and advertising to be able to generate an actual ROI with that. Maybe $250,000 we might be able to generate $1 million in return. So to me, it's just what is the priority of it? In a business mindset, it's not really a smart thing to buy a car or a house or a jet or a plane to be able to satisfy your own personal things. So if you are a entrepreneur that's driving a car or a personal having the jet and all this stuff, I think it's fine. I mean, it's cool if it's a personal decision. I have a lot of colleagues and friends that have these fancy toys, and it gives them personal fulfillment. To me, I'm a very simple, frugal guy, naturally. I'm not trying to be that, so I don't feel the need to actually own these fancy things. For me, it's really about building the business and the whole process for it. I think another thing too is, you know, I know a lot of successful entrepreneurs, and the ones that are the most successful, they don't have fancy toys, fancy cars, planes, or the house. They might have a plane because it saves some time in the business, right? Because time is really the most valuable thing that you have. And so one of these things, when they have all these interactions with business people, and you learn a lot of things from the people that are the most successful. I also know a friend that his business does 6 figures a year, but at the same time, he doesn't actually spend money on his business, but he buys a Lamborghini. And now, to the public eye, people would think that he's more successful because he has these fancy cars, but in reality, it's actually not the case, you know? So it's kind of like a personal fulfillment thing. I think that most successful entrepreneurs I know, they don't have these fancy toys and things because it's really not the most important thing. It's not practical. They rather put that into the business to grow it, or they invest it into another venture or something. It's really up to you, you know, personal choice. But from a business perspective, putting X amount of dollars, $250 million plus into your fancy stuff isn't gonna, how much is that gonna grow the business, right? So one of the things too that I want you guys to know is I'll never get all these, you never see me in a fancy car, even if I have a fancy car. I don't drive a fancy car right now. I drive a Mitsubishi 2017 or 2018, I forgot, RVR, which was like $30,000 in total, right? Now, I'm not gonna go into a fancy car, even if I can, because to me, like I said, I can just put that money into the business and have that grow. And also at the same time, even if I have, I wouldn't, basically, even if I had it, I wouldn't show you guys this luxury lifestyle because it doesn't add any value to you as a viewer. Like, what's the purpose of me showing you all these fancy stuff and just to motivate you? You know, it doesn't motivate you. It doesn't add value to your life. I really think that you should question the people that are showing you the fancy cars, the jets, or they're showing you in the background, you know, using all these video stuff, because the real business people know that that's BS. You know, the real stuff is the work, the grind, 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, you're putting in the work. That's what real business is. It's not when you're driving around cruising in a fancy car or getting on a jet or buying fancy suits. If anybody that's using that type of marketing, and I know there's some colleagues that have it, is they're trying to sell you something, right? They're trying to sell you that lifestyle and that course to be able to hook you in and suck you in. I think you got to think about it in your mind, the real successful people in the world, do they really need to show off to you? You know, the ones that are truly successful that you follow, right? 100 millionaire, billionaires, whoever it is, let's say Ray Dalio, is someone that I respect. He does not talk about his lifestyle, but he's one of the most wealthy and most successful investors of his time. Thanks for watching that BWB right now, answering that question, but I want to hear more of your insights. I want to make sure three things. I want you to like this video if you got value from this, and at the same time, I want you to comment below and let me know, if you were in a position where you had all this money, would you focus on spending it on getting toys, or would you focus on getting it to grow your business even further? I want you to comment below. And third thing is, make sure you subscribe to the channel. I know some of you that watch all of the videos and here, there's thousands of you. And I want to make sure that you're actually subscribed to it, and you also hit that alarm bell icon that's right there. Make sure you get future notifications on videos that are coming out. And as usual, I appreciate you guys' time and attention for watching the videos. I read all your comments, and I appreciate all the messages that you've been sending me and the support overall on the channel. I'm looking forward to building this YouTube community to be much bigger than it is today by giving you actual practical stuff.